Hi, we are Group 6. I'm going to talk about software testing. Our group members are Bhavana Venkat Subramanian, myself Hari Siddharth, Ram Prashant, Sangeeta Swaminathan, and Saranya Damodaran. I'm going to give you a brief introduction about what testing is. So what is testing? Testing is a software development phase intended to show that a program does what it is intended to do and to discover program defects before it is put into use. Why should a software be tested? The two main goals of software testing are, one, to give a proof to the developer and to the customer that the software meets its requirements, and two, to find situations wherein the software behaves incorrectly or undesirably, or when it does not conform to its specifications. We should understand that software testing is a broader software verification and validation process. So what is software validation? Software validation is the answer to the question, are we building the right product? So this means that the specification from the customer and the software we build must match with each other, and there should not be any incoherence. And software verification is the answer to the question, are we building the product right? This means that the software by itself should be correct and free from errors or any defects. There's only a subtle difference between these two. And the process of testing can be understood from this picture, wherein the system to be tested is given with input test data. The system generates output according to its program. So this output will reveal presence of any defects or any other anomalies, and that can be used to understand what error the program has using various methods. So this picture gives an input-output model of program testing. The various steps involved in testing process are, the first thing is designing the test cases. Once the test cases are designed, the test data is prepared and it is sent to the program. The program runs with this test data and generates results. These results are compared to the test cases that were initially generated, and proper documentation is done. This helps in finding any errors or defects in the code and making an error-free code. The next thing is stages of testing. There are mainly three basic stages of testing. One, development testing, where the system is tested during development to discover bugs and defects. Two, release testing, where a separate testing team tests a complete version of the system before it is released to the users. And finally, user testing, where users or potential users of a system test the system in their own environment. This presentation will basically deal about development testing, wherein we talk about white box testing, unit testing, black box testing, and advantages and disadvantages of all these types of testing. Now, Sangeeta will give an introduction and details about white box testing.
Hi, I'm Sangeeta Swaminathan. I'm going to explain about white box testing. It is a testing technique that examines program structure and derives test data from the logic. First of all, why the name white box? It is named so because of the see-through concept. It symbolizes the ability to see through the implementation of the software. In case of white box testing, tester is usually a developer who can understand the logic of the code. It is like work of a mechanic who examines the engine to see why the car is not moving. Now we know what is white box, we will see how to perform it. First step involved in the process is understanding the source code of the application. Tester must be familiar with the programming language used in the application. Next step involves testing application source code for proper flow and structure. There are few testing techniques which helps to achieve this. First of them being statement coverage, which ensures every possible statement in the code is tested at least once during the testing process. Branch coverage test, all logical decision like all ifs should have both decision true and false checked. Path coverage makes sure every unique path through the program is executed at least once. Moving on, let's look through types of white box testing. First is unit testing, where individual program units like individual functions are tested. It is like testing small snippet of code. It mainly focuses on testing the functionality of the method or function. Next comes component testing. Here, the individual units are integrated and tested for error and interaction between them. Finally, the system testing, which tests the system as a whole. This tests the component interaction to make sure they transfer the right data at right time across the right interface. So, the system testing focuses on testing the interaction between the components and objects that makes up the system. Let's look at an example. Unit 1 is a search function that takes in the whole content of the file and a string to search in the content, and it returns the position of the string in the content. So unit testing will involve testing if the method fails, if we pass null values, or when the string is not in the file content. Consider unit 2 is a function that detects keyboard shortcut being pressed and calls the appropriate function. Unit testing for this involves pressing different keyboard buttons and checking if it is recognized. Let's just take unit 3 and 4 as file reading and writing respectively. Unit 1 and 2 are integrated to component 1. Component testing at this level involves pressing the keyboard shortcut that calls search function of unit 1. This tests the interaction between unit 1 and 2. Now the components are integrated to form a system. In our case, it involves opening a file, pressing shortcut that calls search function, entering the string to search, and checking if the output returns correct position of the string. These are the various white box testing types. Now Sharanya will explain in detail about unit testing.
I'm Sharanya. Today I'm going to talk about unit testing. What is unit testing? Unit testing is a level of software testing where individual units or components of a software are tested. The purpose is to validate that each unit performs as designed. It focuses on testing the functionality of objects or methods. Now, why is it important to do unit testing? Building unit tests from the start and running them often during development whenever changes to the component occur can ensure the quality of the software, and also fixing the defects at early stages easier. Let's imagine we are testing a car. A car has subsystems such as engine, steering, brake system, etc. Imagine all these subsystems are bolted together without any kind of testing. At the time when the driver tests the car, let's say the car starts but does not move forward. So what subsystem is to be blamed now? Hence, if no unit testing is done before integration, trying to find out the root cause of the failure is immensely more complicated. How is unit testing done? It is done manually or by automated test cases. Manual unit testing is performed by people. The tester plays the role of an end user by testing all the features. Automated test cases are written in a unit test framework. These test cases may take several inputs and give one output, which is compared against the expected result. Sometimes mock objects are used to fill in the missing parts of the program. For example, if a macro has to be triggered at a certain time every day, a mock object can be used to supply the required time in place of the real object for the macro to run. Once these test cases are written, they are tested on the module. If the expected matches with the actual result, then we either choose to refactor the code, or if the case fails, then we modify the code to run the test again until the test passes. Examples include testing a function, method, loop, or statement. In unit testing, module interfaces are tested for proper information flow. Local data are examined to ensure that integrity is maintained. Boundary conditions are tested. All independent paths are tested to see if all are properly executing. Error handling are tested. Next, we'll see the advantages of unit testing. Unit testing reduces defects in the newly developed features when changing the existing functionality. It also reduces costs of testing as defects are captured in early phase. It improves design and quality. The best practices to follow during unit testing is to develop unit cases that are independent, so that in case of any change in requirements, unit test cases are not affected. Also, bugs found during testing should be resolved before proceeding to the next phase in software lifecycle. Finally, we should adopt the test as you code approach to ensure quality software. Ram will next explain about black box testing.
Hi, this is Ram Prashant. Now I'm going to talk about black box testing. First of all, what is black box testing and how it is different from white box testing? Black box testing is a type of software testing method in which the internal structure or design or implementation of the software being tested is not known to the user. So in a simpler term, it is like a black box in which the tester can't see through what is happening inside, but he can test it. Since the tester doesn't know what happens inside, it is purely based on software requirements and specifications. Example for these types are like the software can be a OS or a website or any custom application, but a tester can test it without any internal knowledge. Next, we are going to see about testing techniques. The first one is equivalence partitioning. In this the input values are divided into valid and invalid partitions, and the representative values from each partitions are taken and being tested. Second one is boundary value analysis. In this, the boundary of the system is determined, and the values that lies at the boundaries and that lies just inside or outside of the boundaries are taken and are tested. Third one is cause effect graphing. In this, like, we identify the cases that are input conditions and output conditions that are effects, and produce a cause effect graph based on that, and generate test cases accordingly. Next, we're gonna see about types of black box testing. There are many types of black box testing, but we are going to check about the most prominent ones. First one is functional testing. In this type, the specific functionality of the software will be tested. In non-functional testing, specific functionality will not be tested, but non-functional requirements such as performance, scalability, and usability will be tested. Next one is acceptance testing, where a system is tested for acceptability. That is, when a software is in final stage of release, it will be tested whether it satisfies the software requirements that are specified by the client and whether it is acceptable for delivery. Next one is regression testing. Once the software is delivered, and if there is a code change after that, like code fits or upgrade or any maintenance, if a new code is added, it has to be checked whether it affects the existing code or features. So that is called regression testing. Next, we're gonna see the difference between black box testing and white box testing. As we discussed, in black box testing, the internal structure is not known to the tester, while in white box testing, the internal structure is known to the tester. Next, black box testing is applicable to higher levels of testing or final levels of testing, like acceptance testing. But white box is mainly applicable to lower levels of testing or initial levels of testing, like unit testing. Since black box is tested in higher levels of testing, it is like tested by independent software testers, while white box is in initial stage of testing, it is tested by software developers. Black box testing is entirely based on software requirements and software specifications, but white box testing is based on detailed design. Next, Bhavana will be explaining about the advantages and disadvantages of black box and white box testing.
Hi there, this is Bhavana Venkatasubramanian, and I shall be comparing black box testing and white box testing for you. So let's get on with it. Before we compare, we must understand certain things. Firstly, both function under different levels of abstraction and both serve different purposes. Hence, any advantage or disadvantage listed is purely relative. Now let's talk about the different purposes. Black box testing is used to complete the product from the user's perspective, and white box testing is used to complete the product from the developer's perspective. Now let's talk about the advantages and disadvantages of black box testing. The advantages are as follows. Firstly, it's efficient for large segments of code, and this is because black box testing tests the abstract functionality of the code and not about the implementation or the details. Hence, the length of the code doesn't come into the picture at all. And secondly, code access is not required, and this is again because it does not check the details of the code, the internal structure or anything. It just tests what the code does and not how it does it. Hence, code access is not required, and this saves us from any tampering or security related issues. Finally, it provides an insight into the user's perspective, like I already mentioned. Now let's come to the disadvantages. Black box testing has limited coverage, since only a fraction of test scenarios is evaluated. Here, see, only the functionality and all the features are tested, and hence you don't check out if there are any bugs or any errors or anything inherent inside the code. So it has limited coverage. Secondly, it has inefficient testing due to the tester's lack of knowledge about the internal aspects of software. Now let's come to the advantages and disadvantages of white box testing. Firstly, advantages. Naturally, due to the internal perspective of white box testing, it's efficient in finding errors and bugs. You know, you check out all the nitty-gritty details, how the code is implemented, all the classes, their details, all the data structures, the structure of the program. Hence, it is efficient in finding errors. It also helps optimize code in the same way. Thus, you get maximum coverage by white box testing. Disadvantages, it draws from the advantages of black box testing, which is intuitive. First, it might not discover any unimplemented or missing features because this does not look at the big picture. It only looks at the complete picture, but you don't get the big picture. You don't see what exactly it delivers. So you might miss out on any unimplemented features. Second, it requires very high level knowledge of internals of software. Generally, developers themselves do white box testing rather than dedicated testers. Finally, it requires code access. Now let's come to the conclusion. Both black box and white box testing complement each other and strive to complete the software product in their own ways. While white box tests ensure optimized code and efficient internal structure, black box tests ensure that the software meets user requirements. Both provide two different dimensions to the software and complete the end product in their own ways. Thank you.